Hi everyone. I'm just gonna do it in Korean. 안녕하십니까? Hashtag marketing 부장 Nicolas입니다. That's the only thing I was gonna say in Korean today. Thank you. So today I'm very happy to be here in front of you. I want to address one of the key challenges we have faced over the last few months, and I believe one challenge like a lot of companies in this industry have been facing, that is changing protocol. Specifically here, moving from POW to POS, and that is the whole scope of understanding the technical development, business development, and marketing. To do that, I need to provide you a little bit of understanding of HDAC and where we're coming from and where we're going. HDAC was created in 2017. We are incorporated in Swiss crypto valley in Zug. It was founded by Chan Dae-sung, who's the founder of Hyundai BSNC. We've did a lot of work over the past few years. We did our TGE in late 2017. We launched our mainnet slightly after that. And obviously we have, as a lot of companies in the blockchain industry, we went through our share of listing on different exchanges, Bitum being the last one in March. For development, we also have partnered with some great companies out there, Orbs being one of them. I saw the guys a little bit earlier. I don't know where they're sitting now. And Strongblock as well is a really good partner of us. So you see, we've did a lot of heavy lifting. We've created our own mainnet. We have developed a private blockchain and a public blockchain. Because you have to understand that HDAC is a hybrid solution, both public and private. We are focusing on enterprise solution, and through this way, we are able to tackle a lot of verticals in multiple industries. You can think of IoT, obviously, with smart home and smart contract, artificial intelligence, payment, etc. So this gives us a very wide range of accessing to different business industries. Through our development, so obviously we have released our HDAC contract and bridge node for the public one, and developing SDK and API for the private blockchain. Right now, what we are focusing on is really like increasing the value of HDAC with the expansion of the ecosystem and service spectrum. One more time. There you are. So you see, like, we have created like a strong foundation that allows us today to make the next jump. So now I want to introduce you Friday. Friday is our new protocol. Friday is based on POS, so proof of stake. I think I don't have to go through what proof of stake is. The reason is we are focusing on proof of stake is because our focus in terms of business development is on IoT. So if you understand the benefit of POS versus POW, you understand that with a focus on IoT, proof of stake is the most important protocol. Performance obviously is key. We need to provide a solution that is fitting what the end user is expecting. So through that, we think we're going to reach a block time of 2 seconds with a realization of 3 seconds. Proof of profession is going to be important for us to realize a fair compensation system. We want to provide compensation to people who are actually contributing to the development. To realize all this work, obviously we need, we're not going to do it by ourselves, and we are going to partner with our friend at Casper Labs. I see some guys over there. Casper Labs is going to help us on doing the development for research and development based on WebAssembly. I invite you to stay right after this session because there's going to be a talk concert between Mr. Chang, the founder of HDAC, and Scott Walker and other people involved in this project. Another point very important is the privacy preserving. So you understand in some industries like healthcare and finance, the privacy of data is very important. So we have to make sure that we are saving that data and it cannot be altered in any way. Coin economy, again, I kind of addressed that in the part for proof of profession, but really for us, the idea is to provide like a fair compensation to the people who are actually contributing to the work here. For human readable account, so we're going to get rid of the X address and focus on 20 characters account. This mainnet will be available in 2020. Before that, by the end of this year, we will have a testnet available. So that's something you want to keep an eye on. To summarize, what we are trying to do with Friday is basically like maintaining or saving a balance between the three key pillars, of consensus. That is privacy, scalability, and decentralization, sorry. Almost forgot that one. So for us, it's very important, and we think like you're going to be a game changer in this industry if you're able to establish a strong ecosystem. That's why HDAC has decided to invest about $10 million in identifying IT blockchain-based companies, and we will provide consulting service, incubation service, and accelerating to make them become a game changer in the world and in the blockchain revolution. We think all of this ultimately will help us realize the strong blockchain ecosystem and become a key player in the blockchain world. To do that, I mentioned a little bit earlier that HDAC is targeting multiple verticals. Here, it's kind of an illustration of what we can do. Both on the public side with Busan City, we can provide like a solution. We also can provide solution on the private sector with high-end tech and JC Healthcare. But also, and because of our let's say, our connection, within the Pan-Hyundai group with Hyundai Motor Company and Heriot, whether you're talking about smart home or smart factory. If I can give you an illustration of what I'm talking here, this is one of the use cases that has been completed. So the proof of concept is actually done. More development will come next year, but as of today, this proof of concept is done. This is something we have developed with a car manufacturer. I'm not naming it, but I'm letting you guess within the Pan Hyundai group, for which we are providing a solution for the manufacturing process, making sure that we are preserving the authenticity, the non-reversibility of the data, and providing like technical solution for the realization of the production. So for example, we will provide like a sensor for the middleware to connect to the blockchain network. As I mentioned, more development will come in the future with other companies within the Pan Hyundai group. Another use case is targeting smart home. So for smart home, here it's a proof of concept that is still being developed, but it's coming soon. Here the idea is to facilitate and provide a seamless experience to the end user in a smart home using connected device, lightning, etc., and making sure like their data is not altered, is not leaked in any way. This is a solution that will be developed with other companies in the future, and we believe we have really high hope that this is going to make an impact. Sorry, I went too fast. Let me go back. Okay. Just to summarize the use case, I want to show you like a short commercial. I know we are running a bit out of time, but it's 30 seconds that will give you an idea of what we are capable of doing for smart home. Of course. There you are.
Yes! They've left!
I used exactly...
I only used...
I just calculated gas usage!
Oops!
HDAC technology platform is smart and secure thanks to the blockchain solution. HDAC technology. Now and tomorrow.
So you understand, like, now for us, the foundation in terms of like technical development it has been really well advanced. The business development part is doing an amazing job. Now we obviously have to tackle the marketing and communication side. With all those developments, obviously, we're going to target like different kind of audience. So it's important to, for us to adjust to this audience. We've explored like different industry, and we find out like through demographic and cryptographic analysis that esports and gaming offers us that kind of possibility. Within esports and gaming, you have an audience that obviously fairly young, that has the capacity to understand technology, new technologies such as blockchain, as cryptocurrency, IoT, that's much higher than other audience, let's say, for example, like an NFL-based fan or NBA-based fan. So their capacity to understand the message that HDAC will convey is there in the first place. Also, because it's still a growing industry, they're not in a phase where they're reluctant to the message of sponsor. They're still very much welcoming a sponsor that will improve their industry. So that's why we are attacking our marketing and communication campaign with four pillars. The first one being esports event, gaming channels, such as YouTube and Twitch, influencers, and esports team. So you will see in the next coming month HDAC commercial explaining the benefit of HDAC for IoT-based solution in smart home or smart factory on those channels. But one of the biggest announcements we want to make is that we have signed a partnership with G2 Esports. If you're into esports and gaming, G2 Esports is the recent winner of the League of Legends European Champions League, and they will be part of the League of Legends World Championship in Paris in a couple of weeks. It's a very exciting partnership that we have here. We think that through G2 Esports social media presence, for your reference, they have about like 12 million fans on all social media channels. Most of them are, actually 50% of them are between 18 and 24, so they will be the blockchain audience of tomorrow. Through this, creating digital content explaining the benefit, the security of HDAC, through messaging via Twitter, via Instagram, via Facebook, etc., we will be able to build the HDAC brand and convey the right message, also benefiting blockchain ultimately. G2 Esports is, by the way, very well known in North America and Europe. So that's a transition for the next announcement we have. We will go on with, we will resume our actions with listing on exchanges. So far, we are very much focusing on Asia market. So I mentioned Bitum, but also GDAT, Bbox, CoinBene. So those are, as you know, focused on Korea, China, Hong Kong, for example. We are announcing today that we'll be listed on LaToken and Bittrex. Those two will open up the North Korean and European, also Russian market. For the simple reason that we want to allow the user to access the HDAC token. We need to think about the whole user journey. So once the people obviously are convinced of the benefit of HDAC, they need to be able to buy HDAC token and invest in the future of blockchain and HDAC. So LA token will be available as right now, and Bittrex will come before the end of this year. We will continue listing on exchanges in the near future to cover all over continents and globally be present everywhere the audience is looking for us. LA token, to give you an example, and I'm sure you know the coin market cap better than myself, but it's one of the top listing exchanges with about 5 billion in volume, and Bittrex has like 300 or so markets available. So we think that this approach, changing the protocol, focusing on the foundation in business development, in technical development, and adjusting the marketing, will open up new possibilities for HDAC and the change the blockchain world. Thank you very much for your time. I hope you stay for the next session. It's going to provide even more information about our collaboration with Casper Lab. So thank you very much.
Thank you, Nick.